Hello. In 2019, I made the world's largest floppy cube. As with my giant 3x3 and 2x2, I made it by extending a mass-produced 18cm cube. Using plastic sheet would have resulted in a better-looking puzzle, but the weight would be too much for the central cube to support. So once again, I used cardboard boxes reinforced with expanding foam. Bashing the edges and corner with a hammer rounds them off. Gaffer tape is then applied to make the rounded edges and corners smoother and to add further strength. It also helps to protect the cardboard from dampness and deterioration over the coming years. A small amount of material must be removed from the two edges of each edge cubie to make room for the pipes that connect to the corners. These areas will also be covered in tape. A floppy cube cannot be made in a 100% conventional way, since the corners would fall off during moves. The two middles need to bend to allow the corner connectors to pass by them during the turns. Once again, I have used cardboard which is bolted onto two more spare 18cm cube corners which have been cut down. These middles are definitely the crappiest part of the puzzle, but it works, so why not? The two middles are covered in the same gaffer tape so they visually match the rest of the cubies. So here we have the early stages of assembly. The central cube has four corners already connected, and I'll add the rest. I'm spraying the central cube black because it may be partly visible during turns. To get the correct spacing, as well as the spare cubies, the edges connect onto two small squares of soffit board and another of plastic sheet. That may sound a bit weird, but it's because you initially calculate what's required, but in practice you find you have to adjust the spacing. This is because the boxes are not perfectly accurate and the tape has some thickness. Here I'm adding washers and wing nuts to the bolts holding on the edges. Later I can tape the doors closed and the stickers will cover them. So that's the edges and corners attached, so now for the middles. Initially I'll just push them on, but later they will be glued. Now for the other side. I removed an edge to make spraying easier, and also to show you exactly how it works. This is an original floppy cube. And as I explained in my other video, it only works because the middle is able to bend. This allows the stems that attach the corners to pass by it. Without the bending, the stems could have no thickness at all. You can see how the same thing happens on my large version. As with my other two giant cardboard puzzles, when you zoom in like this, they look really terrible close up. It doesn't matter though, because when stickered and filmed from a normal distance, they are fine. Now for the last cubie and a bit of lube. When completed, the puzzle is 1 meter square and around 33 centimeters thick. Now for the stickers. I'm using the same 1mm thick polystyrene sheet that I used on my 2x2. If you used this material on a regular cube, you'd have to call them tiles. To me though, they are just scaled up stickers. As usual, I cut the material with a craft knife using a metal rule and perspex sheet. The corners of each sticker needs to be rounded. This actually takes some time since there are 30 stickers making 120 corners to be cut. The cuts can be tidied up with a file and sandpaper. I'm using double-sided tape to attach the stickers and have already put it on each one. All I need to do now is peel off the backing and put each into place. I spoke about the colour scheme in my demo video, but I need to repeat it now for anybody who didn't watch that. The original floppy cube had some weird colours that would have been hard to find. I had lots of spare white, so I wanted to use it on one of the large sides. The popular BOY scheme doesn't work well on shape preserving cuboids. This is because opposite sides can only mix with each other, so the colours need to contrast. White, yellow are similar, as is red, orange and blue, green. I would have used a Japanese scheme, but I didn't have much blue, so I used green in its place opposite white. The rest just fell into place.